All right, welcome back everyone. It's Tick and we're doing some more Oxenfree. We're getting ready to head back up to Harden Tower. And hopefully nothing scary happens because this girl, she might be possessed. So let's head on up. Doot doot doo, little legs, go little feet, go little feet. And that guy just took a brownie when we left off, so he's probably gonna be tripping. He don't know what to do. Dead end right there. We've already listened to the sign the first time we were here. So now for the long climb all the way back up. You can hear the creaking of this thing. Them two better catch up. Cause I ain't waiting on them. I'm going. All right, I'm waiting. There they go. Make me go up here all alone. They're supposed to be the guys. Oop, and I see her. She's up there. But she's standing still and she's not in the room on the radio. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Is she possessed?
This thing doesn't work.
Not getting anything?
I'm getting something, but it's like, I don't know.
We heard you on the squawk box. When I tried it, I just got static and a weird sound, so...
That's about all that I'm getting. Sorry I was, like, weird earlier. But, hey, have you figured out what's going on yet?
You have to know something. You've been, like... It's been ghosts. Nona, ghosts are going on. The blackouts, the hallucinations, it's all been ghosts.
Ghosts? Really?
Yeah. And it would really help if you could just jump to the believing us part. It would save a headache.
That's right. Go ahead and believe us. Because we know ghosts. We are the new ghost hunters. The Oxenfree ghost hunters.
Oh, I got it. This is great. This is perfect. I know exactly what to do.
Do you?
Yeah, totally. It's Maggie Adler.
Maggie Adler.
Yeah, she has a boat. Had a boat. I mean, the boat's still...
Ren, what? You could have mentioned this at any point. I mean, we walked right past it.
I know. I'm sorry. But I've been, like, stewing in my own panic here for the last couple hours. My sister, Allie, worked at the parks office in town. She had to deliver that old woman her mail every day. I know that they have the key.
Okay, so...
We are not. We are not gonna go with the plan. The first plan put forth by the group's resident burnout. Hey, come on. I'm not a burnout.
Well, and I'm not saying it's the best plan, but what other plan is there really, Jonas?
Oh, I don't know. Fix the radio, find Clarissa, set fire to the mug shop. And these are just off the top of my head.
Yeah, I'm still worried about Clarissa.
Wait, set fire to the mug shop?
I'm not saying literally do that. I'm just... There's other things we can do. But there isn't.
Ren, understand, it is completely your fault that we're in this to begin with.
What?
And now you want us to trust you when things are really bad? You had Alex bring the radio. You brought us here.
Jonas, are you serious? This was your fault. Even a blind guy could flail around and bump into that conclusion. You crawled into that hole. You got us stuck.
Guys, come on.
And you tuned into the triangle thing, Alex. So you can't pin the...
Yeah, I tuned into the triangle thing, which, by the way, I can't stand when you call it that, the triangle thing, because you wanted me to.
Even though I wasn't there, I have no problem believing that. It should be obvious to even the cheap seats that you're the only new weirdo who throws this whole social harmony thing we got going on out of whack. I mean, we all grew up with each other. Alex knows
she... Guys, you know there's no television cameras here, right? Take the energy down a notch.
Alex, I am not putting my life in his hands. This whole thing has been a complete joke to this guy. I can't believe you're even kind of defending him.
Jonas.
The stories I heard about this guy, he's a maniac, okay? He's gonna trash our only legitimate means of getting out of here if you buy into this crap.
Legitimate means? What are you even talking about? You have no idea.
Okay, you're arguing 15 things at once now. Do the plan, trust Jonas, leave Ren, like, pick a target, or, better yet, just don't.
Yeah.
Look, I don't care what caveman Jonas says. There
what
is a
that?
Boat at Maggie Adler's house. And the key to her house is back on Main Street.
And the backup plan for when this thing fails spectacularly is two of us have to stay here by the semi-functioning walkie-talkie.
Fine by me. Alex has the radio. Are you okay to go into town? Not that you wouldn't be okay.
Honestly, anything to get me off this tower and away from this specific configuration of yelling people would do wonders for me right now.
You shouldn't go alone. We don't need, like, three of us up here.
Yeah, I'll totally go. It's my, like, brilliant idea or whatever.
Are you kidding? Your food is gonna start kicking in any second. Beyond that, you're a completely unreliable basket case.
I am not a basket case.
Stop it!
Sorry.
Okay, keeping in mind who you've been able to depend on the whole night...
Yes, keeping in mind who you're tired of...
Keeping in mind who's taller, who do you want coming with you?
Nona? Wanna come with me?
What?
Really? I mean, I guess.
Why
this
are you
isn't...
making me shack up with
it's
this guy?
It's my friggin'
We've
plan!
Been together
why? This is why. Easiest question I've been asked all night.
This is a total punt, Alex.
Yeah, this
no,
isn't...
No, it's fine. This'll be a good... If you don't want to take sides, don't take sides. But no... Nobody's happy with this.
Hey, Nona's happy. You're happy, right?
Sure.
Okay. Whoa, alright. We got 4 out of the 5 people back. Let's go check out this broke phone again. Can I not check it out anymore? Oh no. I can't check it out no more. I missed my opportunity.
No hard feelings, right?
Good luck with the thing, Alex.
I should have hit that phone when I had the chance. Great.
I still need you, Jonas, okay? So keep your knee pads on, mentally speaking.
I'll see you when you get back, Alex.
But what about this phone right here? I want to do the phone and the radio. Missed my opportunity. Well, I guess I'm heading on out. We're going to go get us a key. Me and the little girl. Hopefully she doesn't run away on me. Because she's scared to death. Leave the two bickering people here. So they can sort out whatever they got going on. There we are. Down the tower we go. My question is, how do we get back to the main? We had to go down to the right. Yeah, we had to go down. Down, down, down to the field and then over. So let's head on down. Question is, are we even going to be able to make it? Is this gate going to be open? Alright, gate still open. Let's get up out of here.
You know, I do remember you from Mr. Tuttle's class. You sit in the, back, behind Jake. I just forgot. I'm sorry.
Hey, you should be sorry. I'm a personality in that class compared to the rest of those dead weights.
Yeah, no, it's true. I'm also just, like, never there. It's a loophole where, I don't know if you know this, but if you ditch, you get a detention, and if you don't go to that, you get suspended. But suspensions are like paid vacation. You can just do your work over. So,
but you miss the class. Isn't that like the most important part? How do you even learn anything?
Jenny, the TA, she lets me practice ballet in her studio. So, I learned jumping. That's enough. Oh, and Don't tell anyone, but my birthday's in 3 days, and I'm having a thing, and you're invited. I think Clarissa's out of town, so it shouldn't be a problem.
Well, happy early birthday. In my family, we celebrate birthdays all week, so you're 4 days late. You gotta get in the mind state.
Thanks. I'm sorry. I don't even know why I brought it up. That's not true. I was thinking about, I'm worried about Clarissa, and, I was thinking about my last birthday when, actually, sorry, never mind. This has nothing to do with anything. I'm just in a fog right now.
No, come on, I want to hear this. It was last year, your birthday. Go.
Jeff, this was when Nicole was in her car accident, and so of course we cancel and go visit her, and I'm not going to pout about that. It's common decency, it's fine. But afterwards, after this totally emotionally draining night, Clarissa still came over and surprised me with this huge cake. And we stayed up and watched all my favorite movies, and she didn't have to do that.
That's sweet, actually.
Anyways, my birthday's in 3 days, and I just hope she's okay. That's all.
We'll find her, Nona. We're not leaving without her.
Yeah, I know.
That was a good little chit-chat on the walk to the main street, where nothing happened. Check the radio. We're good. It's white. We're moving on. Yeah, she can keep up. Look at them feet go. This place open yet? Nope, not open. Uh-oh, you hear that? Like Jaws music. Doom, doom, doom. Okay, that place is still shut down. Doom, 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 doom. All right, so we need to go left.
So, it's the Parks and Facilities building. That's down a bit, right? If I'm remembering the right building, I don't think it's far.
Yeah, we're close.
Alright, let's get this key. I want the key. The key to salvation. Are we going to escape on a boat? Who knows? But I do know he wants to burn down this mug shop. Oh, change of view.
Clarissa!
Whoa.
What are you... How did she get up there? What are you doing?
Clarissa, how are you not dead right now? Like, swan dive out of a window, empty pool dive, dead.
Clarissa, what...
Oh, there she is.
Christ, what's wrong with her? Clarissa, can you... Can you hear me?
Okay, just what do you guys want? This isn't... this is just really lost its charm, I have to say.
Alex, please, can you just... I don't know what you can do, but can you just do something? Please, just try anything. Like, Clarissa!
This happened to Jonas, too. It's... I don't know, it's like when they want to talk or something.
God. Clarissa, can you... Can you hear me? Alex, come on, just please try and get her down. At least, please, somehow.
Oh my gosh, I didn't even see her up on the lamppost.
Can you come down? She just looks awful.
Nope, door's locked. So, what we're gonna do, we're gonna try the radio. Here's the triangles. There go. That's side number two. Oh.
You think you can control me?
Clarissa. I'm not trying.
No, you're not trying. You're not trying at all.
You haven't changed. Not a bit. But you're a fine girl.
What more can we do? We're barely holding on to
it. What more can you do? You can do your job. That's just for starters. You can be what you signed up for.
When you're off, the little machine has no more heart than a brain.
No more heart.
Man, Nona, what was all that about?
I don't know. Clarissa, are you alright?
You scared the crap out of us.
I'm fine. I'm fine.
Okay. Are you sure? Because that didn't look great.
Do you remember anything that happened?
I remember waiting in Fort Milner and seeing you.
That was a while ago.
How did I get here?
You don't remember how you got here?
Clarissa, you were dead a minute ago. Do you realize that? We saw your body, no joke.
Really?
Okay, well, I'm alive now, so hallelujah.
So you're just blank?
No, I remember something. I remember you with that radio. And I remember feeling like you were the reason all of this was happening.
Uh-oh.
Wait, it's Clarissa's turn already?
Yeah, it's my turn. What do you mean, it's Clarissa's turn already? I haven't even asked one question. Everyone's asking me. I get to do the asking now.
Are you controlling this?
It's, my turn, if that's what you mean. And you, of all people, should know what my question is gonna be, because I'm not gonna waste it. Alex, what did you do? Explain why me and my best friend, and your idiot best friend, and your new
Look, when we went into the cave, we found a thing, and I used the radio to somehow tune it in, and I think it jump-started everything.
I see.
But I mean, come on, like, who knew this would happen? We thought it was a weird trick of light or something.
Jonas, now you're seeing who you're stuck to until graduation.
Clarissa, seriously, I can vouch for this. This isn't her fault.
It has to be her fault. Of course it's her fault. There's no other way this story goes.
It was both of us. Jonas was there too. It's not like I decided to end the world tonight or something.
Oh my god. You see this?
No, come on, Clarissa. Let's not do this right now.
You're gonna learn, Jonas. I swear to god, the town looks at her like she has a red letter tattooed on her freaking forehead. And the giant lit up Christmas tree reason why is that Michael is dead because of her. Because of her.
It would take a very sick person to see it that way, and I would love to hear the explanation.
Michael was gonna leave town. He was free. He was out of here until this one convinced him to take her swimming for one last god knows what. And he drowned. He drowned in Horn Lake while this one could barely flap her arms.
Clarissa,
you weren't there. No one was there, so how the hell would you know?
Everyone knows. Everyone knows the freak sister who let her brother die while she clung scared to the bowline.
Okay, I'm sorry, but enough. Clarissa, that's enough. It's too much right now. I can't believe.
Nona, it wasn't my fault. Really.
Alex, this is none of my business, okay? None. But we came here to do a thing, and that thing is gonna get us home. So let's get home.
No.
Clarissa, what are you-
All the Oxenfree.
Hey, whoa. Man, do you ever get deja vu? Jeez, I just got a serious thing of goosebumps from one.
Oh, constantly. I'm like the empress of deja vu. It's kind of been my... It's kind of been like the theme of the whole night, really.
Oh, I didn't know. Okay, well, the office that we gotta try to get into is like right there. So let's try and whatever our way in.
Whoa, okay. Throwing her brother. Okay, Clarissa's not
we're
up
gonna
on the
tr- lamp We're gonna pole. Try to get into the office thing, right? To get the key?
Yes, we are. But not right this second. We're gonna come down here. And see if anything else is open.
Alex, wanna try and get the key for the gate? You know, the reason we're here?
Yeah. Well, I am. Check this car out again. No, can't do another car. Why was there a bonfire, like, right here? But it's gone now. Alright, let's go try to get that key. Because that's the reason why we're here, right? So let's get it. And where'd Clarissa go again? She just disappeared. She keeps disappearing on me. All right, let's try door number one.
Yep, this isn't budging.
I don't know about that. I think we can just bust our way through, honestly. The lock looks pretty worn.
Bust our way through? What is that supposed to mean?
I think we should try it.
Oh, breaking in there.
Cross your fingers and hold your thumbs.
Do we go in? All right, we're going in. Look at this place. Start at the egg.
I think here's something. It's another pocket radio, I think. But it's like there's way more stations on the dial.
Ooh, neato. Here's another one. It says, they're wall radios? Wave-assisted lock? Whatever that means. Oh, duh. It says right here that each frequency is like a key to open the doors around here. So they're like ID tags or something.
Okay. Cool. Great.
Ooh, wait. Wait, here's like a... Wait. What is this? Personal effects of Margaret Dorothy Adler.
Why would her stuff be here? Didn't her family, or like, hasn't her family been carting her things back to town?
No, we can start back. I just wanna... Okay, here. To who?
Steal a boat and leave.
Whom it should concern. This island and its history is a lie. Jeez, she didn't have fond memories of this place, did she?
What? What could that mean?
I have been compelled by both forces outside of my control and my own willful concern for the safety of others to conceal the many truths about Edward's Island. But now I feel any further inaction.
Forces outside our control? Like ghosts or the army, or what was she talking about?
Let me finish then. Inside you'll find two wall-equipped radios. I have commandeered the old Cardinal Station 140.1 and used it to relay clues to the nearby beacons buried throughout the area. Find these beacons and the notes within, and discover the true chronicle of the island.
Oh, scavenger hunt! Oh, scavenger hunt, scavenger hunt!
wait. To whosoever finds the material, know that I'm discomfited in keeping it hidden and ashamed for the lies I helped preserve. But also know that I acted in what I felt were the best interests for all at the time. And truly, for the interest of time itself, Margaret Adler.
I've seriously had, like, dreams about this. Finding a secret, digging it up, it turning out to be a mechanical unicorn.
Yeah. We've all had the mechanical unicorn dream. But I think I'm ready just to go home. To be totally face up with you.
I didn't get to look at anything else in here. Man. I should not have done the box first. So now what do we gotta do? What do we got? We gotta find stuff. Tune into the radio. I want to go up to the bunker and maybe see if we can't get into the bunker. Because that had a secret. Some type of secret. Oh, what was that flashing?
Oh my god, the Kamaloa was destroyed by friendly fire? We've been lied to all this time.
Oh man, alright. So the USS Walter Roy, a destroyer escort, sunk the USS Kamatoa with friendly fire on October 25th, 1943. It had held a developmental nuclear reactor in its belly and had been sent out weeks earlier as a test of its capabilities. Relatively few even knew of its existence, which tripled the base's confusion when the submarine's communication had been cut off. No one outside of a handful of us would ever know the truth. I would discover later that a weapon technician of Walter Roy had been at Francis Salt's wedding. Salt was an engineer in the Kamatoa. I don't know why, but it's strange to me. Okay. Oh, I wonder if that's part of our letters. Yep, and there's Margaret Alder's letter that she read to us. Okay, look for shiny stuff. Got it. Who doesn't like shiny stuff? Oh, Juke can move. We're going up. So we upgraded our radio. So now we can do more stations. Now, let's get to this bunker and see if I can't tune in. Uh-oh. Oh, what happened?
Alex, why are you wearing that jacket? It's like 75 degrees and the sun's out, you know? And I thought you said you were gonna go swimming anyway. You bring a jacket, but you don't bring a swimsuit.
Oh, my goodness.
The sun is not out. The sun is... I guess it barely came out just now, but... See, this is when I get punished for watching the weatherman. He said it was going to be like overcast.
He said there was a chance for clouds.
Hey, Michael, we didn't bring drinks. Did we?
Wait, Michael?
Yeah? What is it? Did I almost step on a crab or something?
You're dead.
I'm dead. I'm dead?
I think she's talking about the...
Oh, the car? No, they don't... Listen... Mom and Dad know. They don't care. Well, I mean, they cared a little, but...
No, just listen to me. You will drown. Not here, but at Horn Lake, back at home.
You seem really confident. She seems confident. I'm a little nervous.
I would be.
Relax, Alex. I'm gonna teach you how to swim at the pool in the park. Don't worry about it.
Where's Jonas?
Jonas? Who's Jonas?
Is someone else coming?
Yeah, is that a friend of yours?
You want to know who Jonas is? He's my new stepbrother, okay? Do you get what's happening now?
All right. Can you just call your new friend your best friend for my sake? Stepbrother's kind of encroaching on my territory there.
Yeah, it's like when my mom calls her cat her special little lady. It's like, I'm standing right here. Today turned out to be a flawless day. It really did.
Yeah, no, it did. It really did. I wanted to bring a kite, but thought you'd laugh at me.
Carissa, doesn't this... Don't you remember, we're all on the island, Nona's there.
I love Nona like a three-legged puppy, but she would shrivel up and die in the sun.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, she's better off at home, trust me.
All right, where is this thing taking us? We're having a flashback? I don't even know what's happening right now. We're moving. I guess we're going to the beach. I mean, where else do I need to go?
It's been a spell since we did something, right? I feel like I haven't talked to you in a while. How have you been? What's been going on? How's classes? How's... What's his face? Mr. Collins English.
Truthfully, I've...
Ah, sorry. I think... Yeah, I... I accidentally left my phone on the ferry, because I do things like that.
Oh god, you idiot. Go get it before it leaves.
When I get back, I want to hear an Alex story.
Can't I just come with you?
I'll take 2 seconds. Think of something to tell me.
So...
If I were to ask you if you were, past Clarissa. That wouldn't make any sense to you, right?
Past Clarissa? Like am I past the name Clarissa, or... I guess I don't understand.
No, I mean, like there's a past and a...
And a future? Okay, a future Clarissa. You're right, it doesn't make any sense. Sorry. I'm glad we could all do stuff today. I'm glad you were cool with it, I mean. I know you guys are really close, and, like, I know it can be annoying when somebody starts keeping all their time for their girlfriend or whatever. So, I think it would be cool if we could, like, continue to do things together.
Clarissa, no, this is different. He's my brother. I've known him since I was born. He's not just a friend I'm losing.
Yeah, I get that. I get that, and I'm sorry if you feel like you're losing him, because you're not. Michael, he loves you, like, a lot. I'm sure you know that, but he talks about you all the time. Oh, Alex did this, and...
Yeah, well, I love him too.
Had to fight the skipper for it, but he didn't reckon how many squats I could do.
What's it up to, 6?
Only on burrito days. On non-burrito days, it's like 8.
So, apparently, you love me. Is that right?
Well, if I don't, I don't know why I got you that skateboard for your birthday.
You skate?
Not yet.
Yeah, and the no helmet part kinda sends a message, right?
I'm not one for subtlety.
So, I actually really want a cold something, so I'm gonna run into town and get like a soda. Anybody want anything?
Yeah, get me a drink too?
Sure. I'll be back.
Okay, I'm here. What's the story? I want the news. I want the Alex first edition. What's going on?
Things are bad, actually. Mom and Dad aren't great, and I'm like a hair trigger away from spinning off this planet. And...
Hey, look. First of all, Mom and Dad are Mom and Dad. They fight a lot, but they're whatever. Everything always blows over. It's gonna be fine. You're too young. We're too young to worry about marital discord.
It's not gonna be fine. It's not gonna be fine. I know how this goes. I have insider information, let's just call it, okay?
Look, just because Janie's parents got a divorce and made poker nights super uncomfortable doesn't mean ours have to too, all right? And look, I know this was supposed to be our day, but I completely forgot I promised Clarissa I'd do something with her, so thanks for chaperoning. I know it's not what you had in mind, so... But I owe you.
What do you see in her, really?
Okay, Tuesday night, she dragged me to a comedy club for open mic, shoved me on stage, and then proceeded to curse out the entire bar when they didn't laugh at my horrible jokes. And that was a Tuesday, so that's what I see in her.
That sounds awful. Like, I think I've had stress dreams more relaxing than that.
I guess you had to be there then. It's important to me that you like Clarissa, Alex, so tell me the truth. What do you really think of her?
Stick with it. Stay with her. If she makes you happy, if she makes you laugh, who am I to say anything otherwise?
Thank you. Good blessings, good tidings. You know, I never noticed. That's a good-looking jacket. I should ask for it back. I don't like my new one. Feels like I got shoes on my arms or something.
You know what, Bucko? I need it more than you.
Bucko? You haven't called me that in years.
Oh my, flashback or ghost recall? What was that?
Alex, are you... Alright, are you back with me now? Man, you've been acting like a... I don't even know how to put it, like a bird, just flitting around in circles for 10 minutes. I was about to, like, slap you or scream or something. It's been not fun to watch in light of everything.
Didn't you notice I've been, like, gone for the past whoever knows? I was just, like, leapfrogged back in time.
Huh? Back in time? What are you talking about? Really? You didn't leave. We've been here the whole time, both of us. Well, you more physically than mentally, I guess. But other than that, I really don't know what to tell you.
I don't remember being here at all. I haven't been here. I don't know how else to say it.
All right, well, can you just, like, maybe tell me what happened? What'd you see? What was it like? What happened, basically?
It was a day I can remember, actually, when Michael and I spent a random Saturday on the beach here. It was just unbelievable to see him again.
Are you doing okay? Something like that. I don't know if I'd like it.
No, it was good to see him. I'm treating it like a temporary gift. That's all.
Okay.
Alright, so the ghost is giving her live flashbacks. How interesting. Alright, where do we need to go? We're in Effany Field with the others. But where are they? So we can go off that way. I guess we need to keep going to the right. I thought they were in Harden Tower. Huh, the map don't make sense. Did they leave? I don't know, but we're moving. We are moving our feet. And where our feet take us?
Hey, why aren't you at the tower?
This one got a little antsy.
Weird stuff was playing on the radio. That voice said I had a mother's laugh. What does that even mean?
Anyways, are we happy?
We are happy. We got a new radio that's supposed to open doors and gates in some magical way.
Oh, thank God. I was getting nervous that you would have walked all that way and then not found anything. Seeing as how it was my advice to, do the whole thing.
Some weird stuff happened along the way, but, I mean, I guess whatever, that's the new normal now.
Weird stuff?
And we can't find Clarissa, so she pretty much got transmogrified to someplace else.
It's sad that any of those words make any sense to me, but...
Yeah, should we maybe look for her, possibly? Even if the boat plan works, we shouldn't leave her here.
Listen, if we have the key, which is apparently this radio, then let's just go to the house and see. And if it looks like we can leave that way, then we'll go on a Clarissa hunt.
All right.
I think you're supposed to use the radio to tune into the gate, right, Alex?
So are you gonna try the gate thing, or...
Maybe I will. Maybe
if
I will.
If we're still gonna go to the house, let's just do it. Try the radio, Alex.
All right.
I guess the radio will open this somehow?
Hopefully. Give it a whirl.
What's the gate key? That's what I need to know. Adler Numbers Station. There we go. It's written on our map. Nice. Look at all this stuff marked out. Go back to Comm Tower, say Ren, find the key. Steal a boat. We're thieves, look at us. Alright, so 140.1.
Turn on the Lima, India, Golf, Hotel, Tango, for the ships coming home. Turn on the Lima, India, Golf, Hotel, Tango.
Uh-oh.
For the ships coming home.
What does that mean?
Turn on the Lima, India, Golf, Hotel, Tango. For the ships coming home.
All right, I think I got it. So let's open this gate.
Turn on the Lima, India.
Why isn't the gate opening? Alright, do I need to talk to somebody? Huh, I don't know what to do. Turn on the light, it says.
Where are you going? I thought we... Aren't we sticking to the find the boat and paddle away game plan?
Yeah.
Maggie Adler left a bunch of mysterious mystery stuff all over the place, and I'm not leaving until I get my hands on them.
Seriously? That's like a concern?
Okay. But that kind of feels like a morning thing. But sure.
All right, so... It said Lima. All them Morse code words, whatever. Spelled light. And I can't go that way, so maybe we can try up. Maybe we gotta go to that lighthouse now that I haven't been able to get in. Alright, I can't go anywhere. Come on, let me out of here. I think I'm stuck. Okay, what do I do?
Turn on the Lima.
Yeah, I'm stuck here. I can't do anything. It says turn on the light, but there's no switch for a light. Interesting. Interesting. All right, well, I guess I'm going to end it here for now. I hope you've enjoyed it. This is Tick. We're stuck at a gate, and maybe next time we'll be able to find our way through. So, y'all take care and come back, and we'll try and continue on.